गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू एम्स इंडियाज ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सेल, इट्स स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शंस। टुडेज क्लास आल्सो, लेट अस रिकैप्चुलेट द कॉन्सेप्ट्स व्हिच वी हैव लर्न्ड। यू नो दैट सेल इज द फंडामेंटल ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। Cell, it is a structural and functional unit of life. Cell was first observed by Robert Hooke in a dead cork slice in the year 1665, and it is composed of different organelles. The parts of the cell are called organelles, which are specific in structure and perform specific function. Cell wall, it is the outermost layer in plant cells. It maintains shape and protective in function. It is mainly composed of cellulose. Cell membrane, it is also called plasma membrane or plasma lemma. It is a lipoproteinaceous layer. It is selectively permeable in nature. Nucleus, it is a prominent cell organelle. It was discovered by Robert Brown in 1831. It is a double membrane-bound, dense protoplasmic body. It controls all cellular metabolism, all activities of the cell. Hence, nucleus is called control center of the cell. Endoplasmic reticulum. It was discovered by Porter, made up of different structures like cisternae, vesicles, tubules, forms. It forms the endoskeleton of the cells and involves in the transport, especially proteins and lipids. And we have discussed that the Golgi apparatus was discovered by Camillo Golgi in 1898. It is also called dictyosome in plant cells. It is also called dictyosome. The function of Golgi apparatus is secretion of proteins. Golgi apparatus consists of stalks of membranes, bound vesicles that function in the storage. Lysosomes. T. Dew in 1955 discovered these structures. They are fluid-filled bag-like structures found in animal cells only and are also called suicidal bags of the cell. Ribosomes. Pallad discovered the ribosomes. Ribosomes help in protein synthesis. They are often called as protein factories of the cells. Chloroplasts. Plastids are the unique structures present only in the plant cells. These chloroplasts are especially green in color plastids. They perform photosynthesis. They contain green pigment called chlorophyll. Mitochondria. Mitochondria, the meaning is mitos thread, chondrion, granules, was named by Benda in 1897. It involves in cellular respiration, hence called as powerhouses of the cell or cellular furnaces. Okay, let us proceed to today's topic, cell shape. Children, cell is the basic unit of all living organisms, as we know that. It is the structural unit, means all living organisms are made up of cells. Hence it is called the structural unit. According to cell theory, the cell can be defined as the basic structural and functional unit of all living organisms. If you see the shapes, these cells are of different shapes and different in structures and perform different functions. Depending upon the requirement and the location and the function, these cells perform different functions. So living organisms are made up of different types of cells. They are of different shapes and sizes. Today we are going to discuss about the shapes and sizes of the cells. A unicellular organism differs in shape from another unicellular organism. Within a multicellular organism also, there are a variety of cells. Some are long, while others are short. Some are circular, while some are oval in shape. See here. The different shapes here, a muscle cell, conical in shape, or spindle shape. This is the cell of smooth muscles. The smooth muscles are present in the internal organs like intestine, so nucleus, and it is a spindle or oval shape. Next, here see the blood cells. They are different shapes. WBC possess a variety of shapes like amoeboid. Amoebocytes, they are also called amoebocytes. Leukocytes, because they are lacking hemoglobin, so white in color, so they are called leukocytes. White blood cells or white blood corpuscles, they are of different shapes and sizes. So RBC is a biconcave oval shape. So different shapes of blood cells. Though they are unicell, single cell, they are of different shapes. So the internal meaning is, no two cells possess a unique shape. Okay, they are of different shapes and they perform different functions. For example, nerve cell, neuron, our brain and spinal cord are made up of these structural and functional units called neurons or nerve cells. So the shape is like this, the long and slender. They are the longest cells. They are the longest cells. Next, here reproductive cells or gametes. If you take ovum, it is oval in shape, large in size. It is also a single cell. Spermatozoa or a sperm, it is also different shape. So though they are single celled, they are in different shapes and perform different functions. So a bone cell, here another one, bone cell, the cell present in the bone, osteocytes they are called, they are different shape. And a fat globule, a fat cell, they are called adipocytes. So they are also different shape. So different cells in the body, or the various cells from the human body, if you take, they are of different shapes and they perform different function. But one thing you have to remember, the structure is related to its function. The structure is related to its function. For example, this neuron, it's long and slender. The main function of this neuron is, it will transmit the information in the form of electrical impulses from brain and spinal cord to different organs. So its structure is related to its function. For example, blood. The main function of the blood cells is, it performs the transport function. So RBC containing hemoglobin, it carries oxygen and carbon dioxide to the organs. So transport function. Okay, for example, muscle cell, contraction and relaxation. Its structure is related to contraction and relaxation. And fat cell or adipocytes, the main function is storage of fats. its function is storage. So its structure is related to its function, storage of excess of fats. And the reproductive cells are gametes containing the chromosomes, which involves in the heredity, transmission of characters. So like that, the total cells in the body are divided into two categories, that is somatic cells and germ cells. Somatic cells means vegetative functions. Germ cells means reproductive functions. So let us briefly study about the structure and cell size. The size of different cells ranges between broad limits. Most cells are visible only with microscope because they are the smallest unit of living organisms. The prokaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells means the cells with a primitive nucleus or lack of nucleus. These prokaryotic cells usually range between 1 to 10 microns. 1 to 10 microns. And the eukaryotic cells, its range is 10 to 100 microns. It's very big in size compared to prokaryotic cells. The smallest cell, the smallest cells are those of mycoplasma, that is 0.1 microns, the smallest cells. They are also called PPLO, pleuropneumonia-like organisms. Pleuropneumonia-like organisms. They are the smallest cells. And the longest cell of animal is nerve cell. The nerve cell, it ranges about 1 to 1.5 meters long. 1 to 1.5 meters long. So here the relative sizes of the cells, a scale is given here, cells and their components. Here in the electron microscope, by using the nanotechnology, the size of the cell is measured, and when it is observed under light microscope, the ranges are given here. Different organisms like the small molecules, atoms combined to form molecules. It is measured in angstroms. 1 angstrom is equal to 10 to the power of minus 10 meters. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 to the power of minus 2 meters. 1 millimeter is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 meters. 1 micrometer is equal to 10 to the power of minus 4 meters. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 to the power of minus 8 meters. So angstrom. So 1 angstrom to 1 centimeter. This is the smallest length given here. If you observe the range, the small molecules, it range from 1 angstrom to 1 nanometer. 1 nanometer, very small. And if you take the viruses, 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer size. The bacteria, 1 micrometer, ranging from 0.1 to 1 micrometer. Then the animal cell range up to 10 micrometers and the plant cells up to 100 micrometers. Compared to animal cell, plant cell are somewhat large in size. So here the concept is the size, cell size is measured in millimeters or microns or micrometers or the smallest units nanometers. Okay, as we move from left to right, the size increasing. Okay, so the cell size depends upon the size of the organism. In unicellular organisms, the cell size is very small. Okay. So these unicellular organisms we cannot see with our naked eyes because their size is very, very small. So we use the microscopes like light microscope, compound microscope, and electron microscopes. With the help of electron microscope, we can study the internal organization of cells clearly. Okay, so children, that's why whenever you observe anything in the laboratory under microscope, better to make it note, draw the picture which is visible, and try to label the parts, practice it. Okay, so there are so far, once again, if you recall, the fundamental organizational unit of life is the cell. Cells are enclosed by a membrane called as a plasma membrane. It is composed of lipids and proteins. The plasma membrane is selectively permeable. In plant cells, a cell wall composed of cellulose is located outside the cell membrane. And in prokaryotes means bacterium. In prokaryotes, nuclear membrane is absent. The endoplasmic reticulum functions both as passageway for intracellular transport and as manufacturing surface. Lysosomes are the special structures of the membrane bound sac filled with digestive enzymes involved in intracellular digestion. The Golgi apparatus consists of stalks of membrane bound vesicles that functions in storage. Mitochondria are also known as the powerhouses of the cell. There are two types of plastids are present in the cell: chromoplastids and leucoplastids. Chromoplastids, green plastids are called chloroplasts. Other than that, remaining colored plastids are called chromoplastids. Vacuole, this is the vacuole. The vacuoles are the storage sacs for solid or liquid contents present in the plant cells. The vacuoles present in the animal cells, they are different. They are more in number and small in size compared to plant cells. All the cells arise from pre-existing cells. This was a statement given by Rudolf Virchow. Okay, children. So there are several questions ask. Lysosomes are called suicidal bags of the cell. Why? What happens if the plasma membrane ruptures or breaks? Some interesting questions. You read the textbook, okay? Or prepare a model of plant cell and animal cell. So with the help of the available materials, okay, you can draw the pictures and you can prepare a model. Next, what would happen to the life of the cell if there was no Golgi complex? So like that, imagine analyzing. So such kind of questions you will answer only when you understand the concept, when you understand the lesson, when you read the lesson, then you can able to answer. If you know the function of that particular organelle, what happens if that organelle is not present? You can easily justify the answer. What happens to the cell if the nucleus is removed? Okay, what happens if the nucleus is removed? All the cellular metabolism will be stopped. Okay, why do plant cells possess large sized vacuole? Some question. Next, how do you appreciate about the organization of cell in the living body? You have to think and write. The organization of the cell is destroyed due to physical and chemical influence. What will happen? Okay. How could you appreciate the function of tiny cells in a large body of an organism? Okay, we are performing different functions: digestion, respiration, excretion. All these activities, actually, they are taking place at a cellular level. Okay, children? So, as tomorrow, that is 28th you are going to have an exam on this chapter, cell structure and function. Let us go through one exercise. Cell quiz number 5. The nucleus and the cytoplasm together are known as nucleoplasm, cytoplasm, protoplasm, stroma. What is the right answer? Nucleus and cytoplasm together are known as protoplasm. Protoplasm is equal to nucleus plus cytoplasm. Okay. Next, different colors of flowers in plants is due to the presence of cell wall, mitochondria, blastids, nucleolus. What is the answer? Blastids. Okay. These blastids are how many types? Two types. What are they? Chromoplasts. Chromo means colored. So these colored blastids will give the color. Next one is leuco. Leuco means colorless. These leucoplastids, they are present in the stored parts of the plant. The main function is storage of food materials. For example, seeds and stem, potato. The white color portion, that is leucoplast, starch. And banana in the fruit, leucoplasts. And in the seeds, that embryo of the seed is composed of this leucoplasts. Endosperm of the seed, particularly leucoplast. So what is the color of petals given by chromoplasts? That's why beautiful colors of the flowers you can observe in the nature. Cell theory was given by or proposed by Charles Darwin, Theodore Schwann, Matthias Jakob Schleiden. Okay, what is the correct answer here? Cell theory was proposed by, yes, both Schleiden and Schwann. Schleiden was a botanist, Schwann was a zoologist. Both put together theory called cell theory. They proposed cell theory, according to which all living organisms, plants and animals, they are made up of structural and functional units called cells. Next question. Small rod-like structures which oxidize food to produce energy, they are called Golgi bodies, mitochondria, lysosomes, endoplasmic reticulum. Small rod-like organelles which oxidize the food to produce energy. Okay. Yes, what is the answer? Mitochondria. That's why they are called powerhouses of the cell. They produce energy in the form of ATP. What is ATP? Energy currency. Adenosine triphosphate. Okay, when food, which food? Digested food materials. When they reach the cells, there these glucose, amino acids, fatty acids, they are oxidized to release energy. Okay, so mitochondria, B is the correct answer. Next, dash is the largest cell, human nerve cell, egg of an ostrich, egg of blue whale, bacterial cell. Here you need to understand the term largest. Okay, means explaining regarding the size. Longest different from largest. So what is the correct answer? Ostrich egg. Ostrich egg is a very largest egg, single cell living. Okay, next. A cell organelle which contains most of the hydrolytic enzymes is called ribosome, peroxisome, lysosome, mesosome. Okay, a cell organelle which contains most of the hydrolytic enzymes. Come on, children. What is the answer? Lysosomes. Okay, so these ribosomes, they are globular structures. They involve in protein synthesis. No digestive enzymes are present. Peroxisomes, it involves in photorespiration. Okay, present in the plant cells. Next, mesosomes. Mesosomes are present in the bacteria. They acts like mitochondria. Okay, because cell organelles are absent in the unicellular organisms or prokaryotes. So in prokaryotes like bacteria, these mesosomes develop from the cell membrane. They produce energy. But here, according to the question, hydrolytic enzymes are present in the lysosomes. Okay. Next. Reading question is very important, children. Adopt reading the question with concentration. The plastids present in roots, seeds, and underground stem of a plant is chloroplasts, chromoplasts, leucoplasts, vacuoles. Okay. Roots, stem, and underground stem. Underground stem means like potato. So what are the plastids? Leucoplasts, because the stored food material is the main function of a leucoplast. Of course, the vacuoles also store, but in the form of fluids, excess of fluids, to maintain the osmotic balance, these vacuoles are useful in the plants. But chloroplasts, photosynthesis. Chromoplasts, to give color to the different petals of the flowers, to attract the insects and animals for cross-pollination. So here the correct answer is C, leucoplasts. Which of the following is the longest cell? Here the term longest. Longest cell in the human body. Nerve cells, bone cells, muscle cells, gland cells. What is the answer directly? Nerve cells. Nerve cells are the longest cells, several meters in size. Okay. So here the bone cells, muscle cells, and gland cells, they are short compared to nerve cells. Next question. Which of the following is a sac-like structure that store food, wastes, and water? Lysosomes, centrosomes, chromosomes, vacuoles. Which of the following are sac-like structures that store food, wastes, and water? So children, in the exam, Sunday's exam, most of you are finishing the quiz within the 15 minutes or 20 minutes. Actually, the prescribed time is 45 minutes. So read question thoroughly and select the option. Don't be in hurry. Okay. So here the question is, which of the organelles store the food, waste and water? The answer is vacuoles. D. Next question. Which of the following statements is the correct definition of the cell? The cell is the smallest part of living being. The cell is the part that can be seen only under a microscope. The cell is the starting point in the life of all organisms. The cell is the structural and functional unit of life. So you have to consider cell theory, definition of the cell. You can define the cell as, yes, D, the structural and functional unit of all living organisms, or structural and functional unit of life. Okay. These are passageways in the cell that carry proteins, and other materials from one part of the cell to another. Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, nucleolus. What is the right option? The right option is endoplasmic reticulum, transport, cellular transport. Okay. Next. This structure packages and distributes proteins. Packages and distributes proteins throughout the cell. Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, nucleus. Nucleolus, Golgi bodies. What is the right answer? Golgi bodies. Okay. See, most of the cell structures, important organelles like ribosomes, Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum. So they are all, the main function is related to proteins, proteins. That's why the building blocks of the cells are proteins. The building blocks of the living organisms are cells. Cells are the building blocks of living organisms, and these cells are made up of proteins. Proteins are called building blocks of the cells. Okay? And amino acids are called building blocks of proteins. So that's why if there are no proteins, most of the functions, or almost all functions, all enzymes are proteins, all hormones are proteins. Okay? So most of the important vital functions in the body are related to proteins. Okay, children? So that's why you need to include proteinaceous food in your balanced diet every day. Next question. This structure is a storage area for the cell. Plants usually have one large one. Okay. Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, vacuole. This structure is a storage area for the plant cell. What is that? Obviously, vacuole. The large one means vacuole. It is a storehouse of the plant cell. It is also called the storehouse of the plant cell. This structure is a storage area for the cell. Same repeated the question. The answer is vacuole. Which organelle makes ribosomes? It's a dense area of DNA inside of the nucleus. Okay. So if you take a nucleus, the nucleus is covered by a membrane, a double layered membrane What is that membrane called? Nuclear envelope. Okay, and it also contains internally, so chromatin material is present. Along with that, a colored body is present. What is this body called? Nucleolus. Okay, so which organelle makes ribosomes? It's a dense area of DNA inside of nucleus. This is the DNA, a dense area. Okay, it is called nucleolus. It is called nucleolus. Okay, at the time of cell division, it plays an important role. Next. Which organelle aids with the detoxification of the cell as well as makes lipids for cell membranes? Rough endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, Golgi complex. Which organelle involves in detoxification of cell as well as makes lipids or synthesis of lipids for cell membranes? What is the right answer? Smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum. It is the main detoxification, involves in detoxification, means breaking the high toxic materials into low toxic materials. Next. All living cells have this in common: nucleus, cell membrane, mitochondria, cell wall. See the options, variety options are given. So here the answer is, yes, exactly, cell membrane. Okay, nucleus, it may present, may not present. If it is a prokaryotic cell, nucleus is not present. If it is a prokaryotic cell, mitochondria may not be present. If it is animal cell, cell wall is not present. So here you have to analyze the options. After reading the question, immediately you have to think about the answer, and the options which are given, two options are very closely related. Here cell membrane and cell wall somewhat related to. Okay, so cell membrane is the common structure, whether it is prokaryotic cell or eukaryotic cell. Any living cell, cell membrane is present. So last question of the day. These are found in animal cells. They play a major part in cell division: smooth endoplasmic reticulum, cell membrane, centrioles, cell wall. Okay, so the answer is centrioles. Centrioles are present in the structure called centrosome. Okay, there are two centrioles are present in the centrosome. Okay, this is centrosome. At the time of cell division, so for example, nucleus is present, these centrioles will reach the opposite poles of the nucleus and they involve in cell division. They involve in the cell division. So centrioles present only in the animal cells, but at the time of cell division, plants also will produce these centrioles. Okay, children, all the best for your exam tomorrow. Prepare well, read textbook. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel to get latest updates.